I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight.
Oh, hey, Mac. I was you caught me. I was just checking Facebook, but what's going on? Welcome to work. Oh, yeah, that is a nice tie. Where'd you get that? I like it. It's a good color, orange. Why don't you get to work?
Casey Wolf, just making sure everything's still a go for tonight for Mac's birthday. It should be on the phone, Mac. So anyway, sir, yeah, there's nothing really special going on tonight. Got plenty of tickets available and just giving away a bunch of junk at the door. So we'll talk to you later. Thank you so much. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thanks so much for tuning in to tonight's Mascot Game featuring the birthday boy, Mac, the mascot for the Missouri Mavericks, and his team of athletic team mascots going up against the corporate competitors. And this should be a grudge match, folks. It should be very intense, and in case the action gets a little bit too hard-hitting, well, Wes Fillingame, the certified athletic trainer for the Missouri Mavericks, has been asked to stand by, and he has also been asked to take some veterinary courses in case any injuries are sustained by any of the mascots. As you see, the referees, many of the referees, being walked out onto the ice. Now the corporate mascots making their way to the playing surface. Among the corporate mascots are the Red Robin, two Chick-fil-A cows, a couple of slices of pizza, one Mr. Slice from Papa John's and Minsky's Pizza Pie, Bunny, the IHOP pancake, and all 9 foot six of him, Mongo Man from BD's. Mac's team looks this way. From way up north in Maryville, Spoofy, the Spoof Hound from Maryville High School, will have alongside Sizzle, the T-Bones mascot from just across the state line, the Kansas City T-Bones. And from inside the IEC, our friends with the Comets, he is Calvin the Comet. Two representatives from the Kansas City Chiefs, Mini Wolf and Casey Wolf. Slugger, the mascot for the Kansas City Royals, as he has come back from spring training to take part in this game. There you see him sprinting onto the ice surface, and the star of the show celebrating his birthday, Mac, the Missouri Mavericks mascot, as he is just now heading onto the playing surface before some large cheers from this adoring crowd at the Independence Event Center. Broomball is played this way. You use brooms instead of sticks, and you use a ball instead of a puck. Then the competitors, not on skates, they are on shoes, wearing shoes, some of them some very big shoes. As we're ready to go, it will be Mac's team going from left to right from the opening faceoff, picked up by Casey Wolf. He is moving forward, and he fires a drive off the post as it goes in, a score! Mac, the Missouri Mavericks mascot, has given the athletic team a 1-0 lead over the corporate competitors. Well, how about that? Just seconds in, After the opening faceoff, Max scores to give the sports teams a 1-0 lead over the corporate competitors. Getting an assist on that will be KC Wolf and its 1-0 sports team All-Stars as Mac hands off to the Spoofhound Spoofy from Maryville High School. He tries to maneuver through the defense. He pushes it out as it goes into the corner. There you see the T-Bones mascot Sizzle being headed off by Mr. Slice and racing for it. Calvin the Comet, as will he get to that Broomball first? No, diving to knock it away from him. His teammate, Casey Wolf. What's going on here? That was a great defensive play. It would be a defensive play you'd see Derek Pellerty or Cole Rui make, but they knock off opposition players. It was Casey Wolf heading off his teammate, and now Slugger does the same thing. Now there's a big scrum for it in that faceoff circle to the goaltender's right, hammered around the boards. It comes back to the point. Trying to stick handle there was Bonnie the Pancake, but it's stolen by Casey Wolf, and he races the other way. He passes it back to the referee, who leaves it for Mr. Slice, and he is leveled by Manny Wolf. Back to his feet, though, as it goes into the offensive zone for the corporate competitors. Trying to clear it is Casey Wolf. Finally, he finds the handle on that broom ball, and he passes ahead to Mac. Mac tries to outrace one of the cows. He gives a cow a bump, and he maintains the broom ball, moves forward, fires a shot, and the second cow makes a big save. Setting it up in front is Sizzle, a drive, a save, as Mac having words with the cow. I'm not sure they are finished for the evening, and now Mac goes back and says, "What are you doing?" as they are yelling at one another, and a big punch by Mac as he dizzies one of the Chick-fil-A cows, and Mac heads back into the action as it is taken into the offensive zone for the sports team mascots. Mac gets a shot away. That's blocked on defense. Now another effort. There's a big scrum in front of the goal and kicked in by Mac. He scores! And the sports mascots have a 2-0 lead. Both goals connected by Mac the mascot. How about that? As down and out is one of the Chick-fil-A cows, probably still a bit dizzy after being leveled by Mac just a little while earlier. As we see a replay on that, the cow makes the save, and there is Slugger to push it forward. Mac gets his big foot on it, kicks it into the goal. So Mac gets the goal, making it 2-0. Two lamplighters for Mac. Getting assists on that were Casey Wolf and the T-Bones mascot Sizzle. Following that goal, which has made it 2-0 in favor of Mac's sports team All-Stars. You just saw a dejected cow from Chick-fil-A. You know what? They do have some very, very good food. If you get the chance, go over and see Lloyd Anderson and the people there and check out some of the many fine things they have on their menu. Well, here we go. We're ready for another face-off as the Broomball goes in and a score! How in the world did that happen? Right at the face-off, and I think that one will be attributed to Mini Wolf. Playing in his first game, the youngest competitor, and he gets a pat on the back from the Big Wolf, and it's 3-0 in favor of the sports team All-Stars. And the Comet Calvin takes that soccer ball and flings it down into the offensive zone. As I believe play is continuing on, it is 3-0. The sports All-Stars lead the corporate competitors. Now Pizza Pie fires it ahead. That's broken up momentarily by Casey Wolf. Mr. Slice, though, comes away with it, and he rolls it down into the offensive zone. As there goes the horn to end the game. That broom ball picked up by Slugger, the mascot for the Kansas City Royals, and he is walking over to present it to the star of the game, and you know who that is, of course. It is Mac, the Missouri Mavericks mascot, as all of the mascots celebrating and saluting their fans who are up and roaring here at the IEC, and Mac now gets his trophy, which is the broom ball, and Calvin the Comet shakes hands with his friend from the IEC. Mac gets a big congratulations from Casey Wolf, and he heads towards the dressing room triumphant once again in the mascot game. As you see, these fans are just absolutely wired following the fine competition of broomball action we have witnessed here at the Independence Event Center. They can't believe their eyes at what a great game they just saw. Well, thanks so much for joining us. Good evening, everyone.
So look at him. Check the flavor of the rhythm I wrote. And while I get a chance here, let me clear my throat. Oh! Have mercy, baby. Ha! I hope you don't mind. Let me clear my throat. I need these monitors right here. Music in the monitors. And it's gonna look something like this here. Now, if y'all wanna party like we do, if y'all wanna party like us, let me hear you say, ah, 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 ah. If y'all wanna party like we do.
15 seconds to go in this one. The Mavericks about to claim a 5-3 victory over the Wichita Thunder. Sent into the Wichita zone, and Goulet there, and he dumps it out on the right side. And the game comes to an end. And the Mavericks defeat the Wichita Thunder here 5-3 at the Independence Event Center. And the Missouri Mavericks tonight will celebrate a victory that will give them home ice advantage in round one of the CHL playoffs. And that is big. If it goes to five games, that fifth game will be right here at the IEC.